Well, the ghost orchid is really an interesting epiphytic orchid. It doesn't even have leaves, you know. And so it's just a mass of roots, looks like spaghetti plastered out of the tree, that has chlorophyll in it. So the roots are green. So it's photosynthetic root system. So it's a plant that gave up leaves and put its chlorophyll into the roots. So throughout the year, for 51 weeks out of the year, you can walk right by a ghost orchid and not know it. It's just spaghetti green roots. And then for about a week, sometimes as much as 2 weeks, it'll make that beautiful flower that's hanging there like a leaping frog. And so I call it the Cinderella of orchids. You know, it's the Rodney Dangerfield of orchids. It gets no respect for 51 weeks, but for 1 week it makes that beautiful white flower and it steals the ball, you know, so it's kind of a fun. I love the ghost orchid. And the purpose of that flower is that long nectar spur in the back is filled with fuel, energy, carbohydrate, sugar-rich fuel that fuels the flight of the giant sphinx moth. The giant sphinx moth, as far as we know, is the only pollinator that can pollinate the ghost orchid. So the giant sphinx moth and ghost orchid kind of go hand in hand. And so because of the poaching this past, I guess it was around April, we noticed at least a couple of them were missing. And then by June, I noticed a third. So there are at least three that have been stolen this past April, May, June. And so in response to that poaching event of these ghost orchids, we have put up several cameras in different areas at different angles, and we do move the cameras around. And so there's a few of us just monitoring these populations, and we're trying to move them around so people can't predict exactly where each camera is going to be. We just hope that the camera becomes a deterrent, because as a biologist, I'm studying these things too. And then for those of us that are out here that maybe they're not studying, they just want to come out and take pictures of them, they don't want them stolen either, you know. The neat thing about these endangered plants is they belong to all Americans. That's what conservation is. It unites us all. And so one person doesn't have the right to be taking one plant, you know, from 300 plus million Americans. And so that's why we're putting the cameras out. It's merely a response to the poaching. We hope that it's a deterrent so we can stop the poaching. And law enforcement is involved as well. So no matter what facet of nature you want to get involved in, the artistic, the scientific, the aesthetic, doesn't matter. As long as you want to enjoy it and protect it, that's all we're asking. And that's what conservation ethic really is all about. It connects us to people from the past and people of the future. We let the next generation get to continue studying it and enjoying it. So that's why we really are so put off by this whole poaching thing. It's not only illegal, but it steals from the future generations.